The purpose of the fireman's throw is to score points against your opponent. If done correctly, a wrestler can score 3 points and even possibly pin the opposing wrestler. If the throw is initiated incorrectly, the wrestler may only receive 1 point, or the result may be even more severe, i.e., the wrestler may lose points or even possibly get pinned himself.
This is the fireman's throw done by a novice wrestler. Let's break it down. The wrestler on the left, wrestler 1, is in an excellent starting position. His hips are over his feet, his center of gravity is low and stable, and one hand is controlling the opponent's hand and the other is controlling the opponent's arm. The only thing that needs to be altered is his head position. It would be better for the wrestler to keep his head up so he can see what is happening, and to prevent himself from telegraphing his move.
Wrestler 1 made perfect penetration. His back is straight, his center of gravity is well balanced, his arms are gripping tight to his opponent's arm and leg, and one leg is up to initiate the throw. Wrestler 1 is in a pretty good position. He's holding the arm and leg tight, but his motion is in one place, moving around an axis. Wrestler 1's motion should be a forward motion.
Wrestler 1's finish was good for the way he threw his opponent. His hips are tight to his opponent, one arm is around the neck and the other arm is holding the opponent's arm tight. But it would be better for the wrestler to be in a chest-to-chest position where he would have more of his body weight to use. All in all, it was a decent...
Now, this is the fireman's throw done by a more proficient wrestler. The wrestler on the left, number 2, is in an almost perfect wrestling stance. His head is up, making it possible for him to see what his opponent is doing. One arm is controlling his opponent's head and the other is controlling his arm. His knees are bent, keeping his center of gravity low and in a solid position.
Wrestler 2 has excellent penetration. He's deep and tight to the opponent's body. Wrestler 2 has control of the opponent's arm and leg. His center of gravity is centered and low, allowing for maximum stability and power. Wrestler 2 is moving in forward motion, allowing him to use the throw more efficiently, with the least amount of effort and the maximum amount of power. No time is allowed for the opponent to react. Wrestler 2 is pulling down on the opponent's arm and lifting the opponent's leg, causing the opponent to be thrown.
Wrestler 2 is in an excellent finishing position. His weight is evenly dispersed across his opponent's body, making it difficult for him to escape. He is controlling underneath his head while also pinning his opponent's arm between his arm, legs, and body. As well, his legs are tight against his opponent's body, and his other arm is pulling his opponent's tight to him. This is the ideal position to pin an opponent. The second demonstration is a more efficient and effective way of doing the fireman's throw, because there is a non-stop forward linear motion, causing less of a chance for the opponent to react. The least amount of unnecessary movement makes for a safer and more energy-saving technique.
Linear motion plays a key factor in the fireman's throw. When a wrestler goes into his initial starting position, a lot is taking place. As the wrestler begins the move, they lower their body weight, gaining a better center of gravity. This is known as a force of vector, moving in a different linear direction. From here, the wrestler moves in a forward linear motion towards the opponent's leg. This straight motion is known as acceleration. The wrestler then continues in a forward linear motion, holding onto the opponent's arm and leg. As the wrestler applies force to the opponent's arm and leg, they use their shoulders as an axis, and this force and axis act as a class 1 lever. From here, the acceleration continues as the wrestler goes into a side pinning position.